going on, Python? It's V here. I have my voice deck profile. I went on defeated at locals yesterday. I'm gonna show you guys my deck profile, and afterwards I'll give you guys my explanations and my reasonings. It's a 40 card deck, and yeah, let's get right into it. All right. So we had three low, three Sephira, three Divine. I'll explain all this in a bit, by the way. Three Nibiru, three Ash, one Sororus, and one Trias Heraclinos, or whatever it's called. Two of Skull Guardians and two Sora. So this is the monster lineup right here. And then we have for spells, three barrier, three pre-prep, three prosperity, double prayers, double Suopoly, one talents, and one Corbett of Grave. And for our traps, it's going to be one radiance and three imperm. Once again, like I said, if you guys don't know about this deck, I'll do a lot more explanations. After I do the deck profile, I just want to show everybody the deck real quickly. Then we have Chaos Angel, Herald of the Arclight, Typhon, Underworld Goddess, Link Karibo, Double Dynamundo, SP, Relinquish Anima, and then super high targets is going to be Guilty Gear Freed, Entis, Garua, Earthgold Magnista, Draco Equist, and we have Mud Dragon. So that's everything right there. And then we're going to go into the side deck. Side deck needs a lot of work, but it was not bad. It just needs work, though. One Dusta, double Ghost Bell, three Phantasme, three Cyclone, three Soul Release, and three Evenly Match. I wasn't lying. This needs a lot of work. But I will say, like, these cards, some of these cards were just really, really good. I'll talk about that in a second. All right. So what is the basic synopsis of this deck? What does this deck want to do? Your ideal board wants to be Skull Guardian on board with Barrier. And you want to have low, ideally in defense mode. Not that it really matters, but in defense mode. You want kind of want like this, obviously, so you won't get. Anyway, so this is ideally what you want, or technically, whatever. You get what I'm trying to say. And basically, this comes with 41k towers. Your opponent basically has to attack this directly and deal over 4100 damage to this card. Because you can't attack this, and these can't be targets, so you can't, like, imperm. This is also Omni. So that's the ideal end goal of the deck. Now, to get to that board, everything I'm going to be talking about is getting to that board. Every voice deck profile you're going to be watching is going to be talking about trying to get to this board. And the reason why is because once you have towers up, it's insanely hard for your opponent to break it. And even if they do break it, it's insanely easy for you to reset it. So one of the best cards to reset we'll talk about right now is Prayers of the Voiceless Voice. So this card, I'm going to read the specific text that's important for you guys to understand. If you face a light ritual monster you control leaves the field by opponent's card effect, except during the damage step, you can bench this card in your graveyard, Specialman Sororus. So the cool thing is, let's say, we'll have this on board, and this guy's here, and that's in your graveyard, and your opponent outs this guy, okay? Let's say you have low in graveyard, and he outs it, which can happen. Happened to me, actually, a bunch of times. What you're going to do is you're going to banish Prayers of the Voiceless Voice, bring back Skull Guardian, and then Chainlink one Skull Guardian and search for any Voiceless Voice, as well as, I believe, Light Ritual, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, Ritual, Monster, Dragon, or Warrior, and a Voice Support. Voice Monster. And then you activate Lowe's effect. So Lowe's going to special summon back. And now you reset the lock, basically. You're banishing one card. And then Lowe also will activate on a new chain. And ideally, you want to play something like a Radiance or maybe a second Barrier. So Barrier is just as important as these two, because having Barrier up ensures that board state is how you want it, because this is the basic set and the rule that in order to do anything, you have to attack him. So that's why this is so important. So ideally, you want to play two Barrier in case your opponent does stop this. One of the cards that's really good against this deck is going to be Harpy's Feather Duster. Once again, you have an Omni, but if they bait that and dust you, this is different now, because all you got to do is swing out low, and then he becomes 2050, and that's easy to out. So you have to understand that that's one of the best cards to out this board. Radiance is another phenomenal card, because by shuffling in, a Light Ritual Monster or Ritual Spell, you can add or special summon a Voiceless Voice monster. So the thing about this that's kind of wild is, even if you have him up on board, obviously him in like this, and you have like this is in your graveyard, let's say, you can activate Radiance, shuffle in your field spell, and then you can special summon, not from graveyard, but from your deck, another low, and then boom, locks reset. So this deck is really good at resetting this lock. The biggest Achilles heel of this deck is going to be Barrier. This is the Achilles heel. Everyone likes to focus on the front end, when realistically, you get rid of this card, this deck isn't as bad. It's not as fearful. So that's something I think a lot of players have to realize, like, this is the scary part, this isn't. This is just the front end illusion of what is scary, because 41k non-targeting. Your opponent's thinking about how can I get through this? Can I? Is there any non-targeting? Get rid of this? No, 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 no. This doesn't matter. This matters. If you get rid of this, this is a joke. And I think that once players realize that, this deck becomes less fearful. With that said, the next set, we're going to get a bunch of Vox's voice cards, which makes this even better. So lock is pretty good to do now. I mean, my opponent, in one of my games I played last night, he blew my board up, basically. And because I had this on board with this, I was able, with just like my board, like it was like this, with this, just with prayers, reset my board state. So it's very easy to do because you're going to prayers, bring him back. Once again, chain link one, chain link two, boom, he adds. And then this sets another card. Once again, you can set Radiance or you can set another barrier. I personally like to set as many barriers as possible because the more barriers set, the better. M2, obviously, keep one in deck. And then, obviously, Radiance is another excellent card. So that's another thing that people need to understand. Like, once you realize the fact that this deck just needs barrier in order to do anything, it's not as scary. With that said, this deck does play a lot of cards. Like, Suopoly is in almost every Voices Voice deck, and for a reason. Is because if this deck goes second, I can just Suopoly your board away, and you're not that scary anymore. You're not that much of a threat. You're not a problem. Suopoly answers that. So Suopoly is a phenomenal card. I only play two in my build. Some people like to play three. Maybe even considering siding another Suopoly in the future. But I think two is phenomenal. Once again, Suopoly a board away, make it a lot thinner, and then you go ahead and set your Voices Voice. Basically, it's a lock. It's a new Towers Turbo for anyone that played back when Towers. Luckily, we have Prosperity and OCG. They have Extravagance. This card's infinitely better, so it makes us more consistent here in the TCG. This is why I also believe Voices Voice will be more prevalent, because one, players don't understand this, so players playing Voices Voice get free wins, because people are going to be focusing on this rather than the barrier, so that's cool. But two, and most importantly, this keeps a better version of consistency than Extravagance. And OCG Extravagance is at one, and Voices Voice was doing decently, but here in a TCG, we have it at 3, and I think it's going to do better. And with the new support, this will be just as good, if not better, than Fire Kings eventually. That's my opinion. I own both decks, and I'm telling you right now, this is just as good as Fire Kings with the next core set. So by Nationals, if this doesn't get touched, which it probably won't be, this is going to be one of the best decks. So keep an eye for this. Pre-prep is a broken card. Another thing about Voices Voice, too. So drawing Lockboard is really good against a lot of decks. With Voices Voice, it's not that good. If I pre-prep and you draw me and I have low, a way to get the low and whatnot, I'm just going to just blast right by everything. So I got drawed yesterday a couple of times, I think two or three times, and I still set my board up like it was nothing. You don't need draw. I mean, if they draw you, it's whatever. I think there are better cards to play against this deck than draw. So Sovaris is a great card. The cool thing about Sovaris is it's an inherent negation on board, and then once it bounces back to hand, it's a target negation. So once you set up Skull Guardian with low, my next goal would be setting up Sovaris. And the best way to do that, obviously, is going to be the other Sovaris. His effect, though, you have to return a ritual spell from hand or graveyard, as well as any spell from hand or graveyard. I'm not sure if it's field, actually. It's hand and graveyard. Hand and or graveyard into the deck. You put it back to the deck, you special on the hand, your opponent activates a card, return it back to the hand. You bring out Sovaris. Sovaris has to will return back to your hand at the end of your next turn. At the end of the next turn. So he's pretty much going to guarantee get that Inherent Summon negation. Inherent Summons on Star Chain. So that's important rulings. But once it goes back to your hand, once again, now he's target negation. Which is really cool. Unfortunately, Sovaris only protects from monsters being targeted. I wish this card read protect from any card being negated. Because if that was the case, that would make your barrier lock infinitely better. But it doesn't. But man, that would be cool. Okay. Another cool thing about Sovaris is, obviously, if you bring out low, it gets imperm, you can protect it with Sovaris. That also did come up for me. Trias Herkleiner, Hercurlier, what the fuck? This card is the goofiest name in Yu-Gi-Oh! History. We'll just say Trias, because let's be lazy. So, for anyone that's known this little combo, it's the cutest little combo on the planet. Normal summon divine effect, you send Trias. This is always what you're going to be sending as your first effect. You send Trice to the graveyard. Trice is going to tribute Diviner. Diviner has another effect. If it's tributed, you basically get the special from low. Bring out low. Low effect. Bring out barrier. And then from there, you get to continue combo. Depending how you want to do it. If I do barrier, what I'm going to do is I'm going to activate barrier. Add Sephira. Once again, this is off one card, by the way. Add Sephira. Let's say we got drolled. No big deal. Actually, it's kind of big deal. But it's hit or miss, like I said. Okay, Severe Effect. We're going to go ahead and send a Ritual Spell to the graveyard. We're going to go set, and then that'll let us add Lezzat Skull King, Severe's other effect, Banish, get rid of Trias, and then Lock Enabled. So, without me babbling, I'm just going to show this combo to you again so you guys can see. It all starts with one Diviner. Okay. Summon Diviner, Diviner effect, send Trias, Trias effect, Tribute Diviner, Diviner's other effect, bring out Low, Low's effect, bring out Barrier, Barrier's effect, add Saphira, Saphira's effect, send prayers to add Skull Guardian, and then Saphira's other effect, by banishing it, we can get rid of Trias, and then go right into, Skull Guardian. Now, Skull Guardian has other effects when he hits the board. Obviously, he gets an Omni, by the way, if Low's on board, but when he hits the board, his other effect is going to allow us to add a Voice's Voice. At that point, it's up to you what you want to add. You can add Radiance. Radiance is not bad if you kind of want to reset the board state. Also, we have, once again, Praise and Graveyard, so we're kind of locked into that. So, we're locked into... If our board gets stopped, we can kind of reset our board with Prayers and Graveyard. Radiance will also ensure a better game state. But once again, if I'm playing against a player who knows how to play against his deck, what I would do, rather than get Radiance, I would just get another Barrier. Because, like I said, this is a pain in the ass to out. Throw another Barrier on board. So now, if he had, like, Phoenix Nightmare, let's say, and he bait out Omni Gate, a Phoenix Nightmare clears this. I mean, this is just easy pickings. So what we want to do is we want to go double barrier, just to make sure that it's a little bit harder to get rid of our board state. And once again, this is going to help us out and protect us against that kind, those kind of cards. So that was all from a one card combo, by the way. And this deck has tons of that. I mean, there's tons of instances of that. Obviously, if you open Low, you kind of could do basically do the same exact thing with Low as well. So just more cool stuff that this deck can do. I'm trying to think of anything else that would help you guys out. Like I said, I built this deck because I feel like this is going to be a tier one deck. But at the same time, I don't think it is a tier 1. I think it's a 1.5 deck. I do think Fire Kings is still better. A player who knows how to play against this deck will have a massive advantage. A player who does not know how to play against this deck will just be the buy. Yesterday, obviously, a lot of players did not know how to play against this deck, and people were making mistakes left and right. But I think that one of the biggest mistakes against this deck is not reading the novel of card text. All these fucking... look at this. Dude. This is... Matt, look at this. What the fuck, dude? And all these cards do so many things. So you have to know what it does and you have to respond accordingly. And once again, I think a lot of players that I played against and more likely will continue to play against within the next week or two, especially if you're going to regionals, they're going to read these cards, say, okay, you're going to lock the board state down, and they're going to say, what do I do? Oh, I'll just focus on Low. Okay, target Low. I'll focus on the dragon. Okay, target dragon. I'll beta Omni again. You're like, whatever, dude, here. Like, everything your opponent does puts him in a bad situation. I do think Triple Tactics Talents is a very good card against this deck. So that's another thing I want to talk about as well. If anyone else play against this deck, obviously Super Pie is really good as well. But Talents is insane because Skull Guardian is an Omni Negate. So if you bait the Skull Guardian Omni Negate, you just go Talents and take. Non-targeting removal or non-targeting card effects impact this deck heavily. And if your opponent has a board state like this with Barrier on board, and you bait this negate, you just go Talents, your opponent says, fucking sure. You really put him in a bad spot, because then you're going to take this guy, you do the rest of your board state, enter battle phase, kill, and, there's that. So, I mean, there's some cool little things you can do. Obviously, you got to keep an eye on Prayers of Voice's Voice. It's really important, because, once again, if a face-up light monster, face-up light ritual monster you control leaves the field by your opponent's card effect. So, very important. Very important. And specifically says card effect. So, by taking this and somehow linking it away, it won't be too bad. Another thing I'm seeing a lot of players that play in the side deck, extra deck, is they're playing, like, Charmers. So, like, Light and Dark Charmer. There's no reason to play Charmers if you're not going to go into, like, an Axis Code Talker. It just, I don't know, I don't understand why people are doing that. Like, it's so goofy, bro. Just play two Dynamundos, like, the most important card in your extra deck. Like, this right here is infinitely important. Once again, Dynamundo is basically the same exact thing. If you feel like your opponent can't stop what you're going to do, Dynamundo, a Dynamundo effect, attributes itself, brings out this guy, Chain Link 1, Chain Link 2, resets board state, under a barrier, of course. Once again, it has to always be under a barrier in order to ensure the lock. So this card basically is another card to reset your board state. If you have another two set of monsters, doing it like this is also crazy. Because your opponent still has to deal with this shit. And the second he does, you just Dynamono reset. So this is a really cool board state. This is probably your ideal board state. Plus or minus of a barrier or the trap. So really, really cool as well. I think that's basically all the information about Voice's Voice, guys. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments down below. Once again, I think this is going to be a really good deck for a very short amount of time until everyone realizes how to stop it. Once they do, it's going to be problematic. So that should be like your main focus point. For the side deck, you might want to consider cards like Solemn Judgment in the future, and that's because protecting your back row, protecting your board state is important. Cards that evenly match hurt a lot. Once again, this card hurts a lot. A Duster hurts a lot, Cyclone hurts a lot, and they're all on everyone's side deck. So game one, I think you have a huge advantage. Game two becomes infinitely hard, and you might want to consider cards like evenly matched in your side deck just to help you out a lot. Soul Reese was insane for me. Yesterday's card's broken. Cyclone's also just a really good card now. I also like Phantasme, once again, good against fire decks. And, you know, Bell and Duster. Another card I would consider playing would be Drone Lockbird. Even though I said it's not good against this deck, it's still really good against everything, particularly Fire King. So that's another card that I might want to consider playing. Once again, this is a 40-card deck. I do run 9 hand traps. I would love to up that. You could say 11 if you want to include Seal Poly. I want to disagree with you, but I would love to add 3 more hand traps in here, but I don't want to surpass 40. It's very important. Like, this deck was insanely consistent yesterday, and then one of the biggest things is I don't want to be not consistent with this deck, so that's what I'm at right now, 40 cards. I'll try to fit room for more hand traps. I'm not going to get rid of Triple Attack of Talents. That card's insane, but who knows? We'll have to see. Alright guys, so this is the Voice of Voice deck. I'll probably play this deck some more. I have a bunch of other decks coming up. I'm going to be playing basically every deck in this new set. And I'm going to be streaming on Twitch.tv YJO_Paisano. If you guys want to check that out, once again, Twitch.tv YJO_Paisano. I'll have the link down below in the description. This deck's really good. And if you're playing this deck, you're probably farming locals because nobody knows how to read any of this shit. It's your boy V, and you Paisanos have a great day.